welcome. My name is Lindell Soul, and I will be your guide for today's virtual Jane's Walk. I work for the North Brooklyn Park Alliance, which is a local nonprofit that advocates for equitable, vibrant, and connected open space in our district. And they've been doing this work for almost 20 years now. So today I'm really excited to introduce you to this space. Because of the pandemic, not very many people have seen this space, so this is a big treat. However, let's take a minute and talk about our birthday girl, Miss Jane Jacobs. As many of you know, Jane Jacobs is considered a famous urban activist. So famous, in fact, that each year since her death in 2006, people all over the world come together and celebrate her life by giving these walks in her name. However, Jane didn't consider herself an activist. She actually considered herself a writer. Jane came from a middle-class family from a coal town in Pennsylvania, and she moved to New York during the Great Depression, where she began her career as a freelance writer. In fact, her writing career was bookended on either side by the Great Depression, and then on the end with the events of 9/11 in 2001. What made her most famous was her writings in the 1960s. In particular, a book almost everyone knows, if you know Jane Jacobs, The Life and Death of the Great American Cities. But what set her life apart as a writer was that she didn't just write exposés about what was wrong. She offered carefully prepared proposals on how to fix things. Now, let's say you never read one of her books and you have no idea who this lady is. That's absolutely fine. If you're a New Yorker or you love New York, then you owe this woman a debt of gratitude. She was also best known for rallying her neighbors in the West Village to stop a proposal by the master builder named Robert Moses and his project to build a highway right down the center of Washington Square Park. I know, it's absolutely crazy. A highway right down the center of the park. It goes without say that that was not one of his most popular ideas. And with that win, she took the wind right out of his sails and changed the course of how the city planned in the future. Which kind of brings us to this space here today, a park under a bridge that connects a highway that Robert Moses built and that has scarred my neighborhood for almost 60 years. So why build a park under a bridge? Well, cities all over the world are looking at public space and they're asking themselves, how can it be better used, be made more equitable, and become more green, smart, and connected? One such place that often excites city planners and architects are these places called L spaces. L spaces, EL-spaces. L spaces are commonly found under elevated highways, trains, or bridges. L spaces can be contentious places. They often divide communities and can be seen as dangerous or dirty. Adding to the challenge, they tend to be complicated jurisdictionally, being administered by like an alphabet soup of federal, state, and local agencies. However, what if an L space could be used as a positive force to add to public space in the cities that desperately need it and stitch back together places that have been driven apart? So here we are, in one such place. Under the Cambridge Park was born out of this very notion. With funding from the Greenpoint Community Environmental Fund, or we all call it the GCEFT, North Brooklyn Park Alliance commissioned Public Work, our firm responsible for the Bentway in Toronto, for a community-driven process that went on for almost 2 years and resulted in the design you see here today. Building the park was funded by the governor of New York and was led by the New York State DOT. Construction began in the fall of 2019, and despite all the challenges of the pandemic, the park was actually completed in August 2020. Although the serious nature of COVID has kept us from opening the park full time just as yet. This L space offers a contrasting vision for waterfront development, one that goes a little slower, builds consensus, and looks to steward the area like our neighbors at Newtown Creek Alliance or the Gowanus Canal Conservancy. The challenge here is that the park is lodged between heavy industry and a densely populated residential area. This 7-acre space is doing an awful lot of hard work. Over 20,000 new trees and native plant species are attempting to remediate the natural environment. Pollutants from the highway above, loose trash and dust from all our neighbors around, and the remnants of the ExxonMobil oil spill are all challenges that don't go away just because we converted an L space from unused to used. Despite that, Under the K is becoming a destination, defined by the bridge's soaring concrete columns that extend from 40 feet at the entrance of the park and up to 110 feet right here above the water. Under the K is at once a park and a series of massive industrial spaces. We begin on the arm, which is a linear promenade that receives pedestrians and cyclists from along the footpath of the bridge above and brings them into the main spaces. Flex 1 is the first main multifunctional zone that's geared towards rotating programming, community activities, and play, and is completely adored by the skater community. Flex 2 is a massive space with the capacity to host large-scale events, performances, and recreation, unlike anything we have available to us in North Brooklyn. And finally, Creekside, where I am sitting right now. Creekside is special. It celebrates the prime position along the water's edge with public outlooks and seating and a restorative landscape of native plant life. One day, we hope that we'll be able to extend this natural amphitheater down to the water's edge and connect more fluidly with our neighbors on the Queen side. While it's too early to say if this L space can repair decades of the negativity that highways can bring to an immediate area, we think Miss Jane Jacobs would be proud of our attempt. So with that acknowledgement, I'll leave you with this message from our Jane Walk host, the Municipal Art Society. In addition to organizing the Jane's Walk each year, MAS does the hard work of advocacy and education on the public's behalf every day for the last 125 plus years. They are at the forefront of sensible city planning, preservation, and policy. I'm grateful to have them in the city and delighted to have you all join us on today's Jane's Walk. I hope you'll get more involved with their organization and with ours, and I hope you feel empowered to learn about your community and tell its story. So thank you all. And that's it for today. I hope you join me tomorrow. Thank you from Jane Jacobs.